This steel truss bridge had three center piers, and experts we talked with questioned why the bridge piers were so close to the shipping channel. They say the bumpers, if they had bumpers, could have helped, and we're told after 9/11, state officials discussed putting bumpers on those piers to actually, you know, act as bumpers, but we were told that it was too expensive to do. We talked by Zoom to a bridge expert from Johns Hopkins and Drexel Universities.
But the way that it collapsed, and I think that was surprising to some people in particular, because one of the piers was hit, but all three of the spans collapsed. And that's a function of the continuity of the bridge. So there's a lot of load sharing that goes on among those three spans. And so if two of them are damaged or destroyed, as was the case here, by their support, their direct support being removed, then the third span is going to be severely impacted, in this case collapsed as well.
But I think they would have been effective in this. At least they would have reduced the impact, or at least prevented the ship from impacting directly those, you know, impacting the piers directly. Because I mean, the way it went, I mean, it was just almost, you know, effortlessly, it seemed. I mean, the vessel hit the pier and it just went. I mean, there was no hesitation. The bridge did not hang on at all. And so I think the fenders or the bumpers would have helped.
The Key Bridge was last inspected by the state in May of 2021. It was declared in fair condition. Governor Moore this morning told reporters the bridge was, quote, fully up to code. Reporting live from the newsroom, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.